How's it going, everyone? Today I wanted to make a video on how to improve your proficiency exercises. For those of you that work for other departments, a rookie drill or probationary drill is the same thing as a proficiency exercise here at the Los Angeles Fire Department. I know that some people are looking for tips and ways that they can get better at giving their drill, or they just want to know how to present it, and we're going to be covering that in this video. Tips for improving your proficiency drill. Presentation. Remember, you're putting on a presentation, so the way that you present the drill, the way that you talk, the way you vary your voice, not being monotone, the way that you try to capture your audience, consider the audience. Sometimes they're going to be sitting in lazy boy chairs, sometimes they're going to be sitting in outside lawn chairs. You don't want to put the guys to sleep. Make sure you have a good pace. Try to limit the number of times that you say the word and just all those basic techniques that you use in your interview, they all come into play when you start doing your proficiency drill. The other thing is preparation. I can't stress enough how important preparation is. You want to make sure that you're at least three drills ahead when you're giving your drill. So at the day of your drill, you already have three or two more drills set to go to talk to your guys. And for preparation, also comes research. You want to make sure you're reading the books, reading the reading material in your fire station or however your department has it. Make sure that you read owner's manuals when it comes to equipment and just do some research on your topic. The other main thing is, and this is the most important thing, you got to talk to your firefighters. Have the information that you've already read and present it to the firefighters ahead of time. Start with your chain of command. Remember, the firefighter with the least seniority all the way to your senior firefighter and then your rated members or your drivers, your AOs, the experts. You never know which one of your firefighters at your station is going to be an expert in that subject. Let's say chainsaw. You got a guy who was worked in the wildland fire service and he was a sawyer. You know he's going to know his stuff about the chainsaw, so he's going to have some trick things that he can give you and you can present during your drill. So make sure you talk to every single person. That's important. Organizing your drill. To make a smooth, easy drill, you want to make sure that you're organized. Here are some categories that you can use for every single one of your drills. Make sure that you list your references in the beginning of the drill. Then you state the name of the drill, the name of the equipment, and then maybe even the nickname, and the things that people know the tool as, such as chainsaw. Then you want to go into who carries the drill. So for who carries the drill, you want to make sure that you call your specialty fire stations like your hazmat units, your USAR units, your fire boats, or your helicopter units. See if they carry that equipment and if they have a specialized version of it. The purpose of that tool. You talk about the purpose of that tool, the objective, the reason why you use it, then you want to jump into specs. For specs, hey, you know, there is no limit on specs. You can go real deep into the material, especially in the owner's manuals and the books about the specifics about that tool. Then you want to go into safety, everything that has to do with the safety of that drill or that piece of equipment. And you also want to go into your checks, what you're doing on your daily check, your weekly check, your monthly check. And then if there's an annual check of some kind, make sure you have that included in there. And then you come down to your operation. They're going to want to see you use the tool. They're going to want to see you use the tool practically. Know how to start the tool. Know how to troubleshoot the tool. Know how to use the tool in all the different ways. They're going to show you that when you approach them and say, hey, I got a chainsaw drill coming up. This is the information I know. Can you show me what you know about operating it? So you're going to look really good if you have a good operation and also troubleshooting, knowing how to take it apart, put it back together, fix a problem on the spot. Remember, you're the probationary firefighter, so you're Johnny on the spot. You got to know how to fix everything. You got to know where everything is and how to use everything. And day one, you're accountable in this department to know how to use all the equipment and to know where everything is. That's a lot of pressure. So that's the purpose of these drills, to get you going as soon as possible so you're contributing to the fire company in a positive way. For operation, you can set up props, like if you're doing a rotary saw drill, you can cut some rebar or show that you know how to operate the tool in a practical setting. Say you have a yard in your fire station, you can learn how to cut with the tool, and they're gonna wanna see that definitely. That is probably more important than any spec or anything that you can put to memory, is actually using the tool. So be prepared to use that tool. Some extracurricular tips I wanna give you guys. Hey, if you got a drill on building construction, or you got a drill on some specialty thing, you might have to go above and beyond. You really wanna try to impress these guys. If you wanna go and talk to like an architect who is specializes in a certain type of building that's in your department, in your fire district, that's an excellent way to go about it. If you're doing a ladder drill, hey, go to the company that manufactures the ladder and talk to them about the history of the company and how they make it, the little process. The point behind that is you're looking for that little golden nugget when you're giving your drill. If you could find something that the other guys have never heard of or don't know, that's gonna set your drill over the top. So it might sound like a lot, but honestly, that's kind of expected here at the Los Angeles Fire Department. And if you work somewhere else, this is just gonna put you over the top. Like, wow, he went to the manufacturer, he talked to them. So that's just another tip for me to give to you guys. All right, that's all I have for a proficiency exercise. And if you have a question, please leave a comment below, like and subscribe if you want to. And just want to let you know, don't be overwhelmed by the drill. This is your opportunity to show the guys that you worked hard, you learned the things, and that you really want to be there. So just show your preparation, and it will all go fine.